Hello everyone, we're back for our next economics lesson, lesson number 5, all about resources. When you open this up, you're going to see there's a few things here. So right here, you can read this again for notes about the lesson, resources, that's the slide deck. But there's also another video all about thinking about our natural resources, and that's what the discussion board is going to be about today, all about natural resources. But I'm going to open this up, you can explain this again for notes about the lesson. Remember, if you ever do open it up, sometimes it opens a little slow, so just be patient, and it should open up. And there it goes. And, you know, one thing, too, if ever it's going really, really slow, up in the top right corner, you can always hit that button, the three dots, and you can view the web version. But I'm going to hit the next arrow here, resources. I can identify the three types of resources. I can identify the resources needed to produce a specific good or service. And so you're going to so I'm not going to explain a little too much more here, but basically a resource is something that you use to make a good or provide a service. Some vocabulary words. Capital resource. That's a man-made, as I always like to say, human-made good used to produce a good or provide a service. So those are things that are made so you can do, or so you can make another good or provide a service. Human resources. People who do the work. Natural resources. Those are things from nature to do a good or a service. In the last lesson, you learned more about producers and consumers. In this lesson, we're going to focus on learning more about producers. Remember, producers are people who make goods or services. So like in that picture right there, that's a service, people on window washers. In this activity, you will choose a producer from the right that you would like to learn more about. Read or listen to the information about that job, then complete the activity workers in the community. Again, I'm not going to be able to open up these links, but what these do is they bring you to different websites just to learn more about these different people. And then you can also click on that link, then, workers in the community, just to do some thinking about those kinds of jobs. But there's veterinarian, pediatrician, librarian, utility worker, pizza maker, firefighter, mayor, police officer. Then there is another quiz there. Take this matching producers quiz. And it's another really fun part. Now that you've learned about different producers, it's important to understand that producers need resources. Producers use three types of resources. Capital resources, human resources, natural resources. Capital resources. Capital resources are goods made by people and used to make other goods to provide services. Pencils, scissors, desks, and chairs are capital resources we use in the classroom every day. So pencils, scissors, and desks, and chairs are made so like we can do our work for school. Human resources. Human resources are the people who do the work. In our school, some human resources are teachers, custodians, secretaries, and the principal. If you think about like even like a grocery stores have lots of human resources. All the people who are stocking shelves, the cashiers, the managers, people who are working in the deli or the bakery. Those are all human resources. If you said cashiers, deli workers, bakers, or workers to stock the shelves, you are right. Natural resources. Natural resources are found in nature. They can be used to produce goods we want. Some example of natural resources are sunlight, trees, soil, coal, oil, and water. So if you think about just what the natural resources a farmer uses all of it. They use the sunlight to help grow. Trees, some can be like a really good wind block or to make, you know, it can cut down a tree for the wood to make new things around the barn around a farm that you might need. Soil to grow, coal for burning for energy, oil to run any of the farming equipment, and water, again, for lots of different uses. In this activity, mystery workers look at the picture of the construction site, use an arrow to show a natural capital and a human resource. So it's kind of a cool way just to practice, be able to know those different resources. You're going on to resources hunt. Watch this video to learn how honey is made. Watch closely for examples of capital, human, and natural resources. When you're finished watching the video, see how many of the three resources you can remember on the resources hunt activity page. You can go back to the video if you need to. Yep, so I won't be able to open it because it'll kick me off my recording app, but you can watch that. You can do that activity too. It's really fun. And the video is so cool too. Are you ready to show your understanding of resources? So now this is where you can do a practice activity, a producers use resources, sorting resources. So it's really fun there. Okay, and now I'm going to go to the discussion board. So remember, there's also a video all about natural resources. Watch that video because it just shows you some things about natural resources. Then you get to do this discussion board, thinking about natural resources. To finish our lesson today, think about natural resources from the video. How can you conserve or save our natural resources? Then respond to at least one other person's answer with a question, a comment, or a connection. And really, I'm asking this question just because we have all these different kinds of resources, and our natural resources, those can run out. Our coal, oil, trees, water, clean water, those things can run out. And so how can we conserve or save or use less of our natural resources? I'm really excited to read that thinking. And yeah, have fun, everybody.